The U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service estimates that 500,000 to 1 million birds are lost every year in pits used in the exploration and production of oil and gas. In this presentation, we will look at the risks to birds and other wildlife at oil and gas facilities and best management practices that can be used to prevent this mortality. In 1997, the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service estimated that 2 million migratory birds were lost each year to oil pits throughout the United States. Since 1997, many oil operators have taken measures to prevent migratory bird and other wildlife mortality in oil field waste pits. Currently, an estimated 500,000 to 1 million birds are lost annually in oil field production skim pits and centralized oil field wastewater disposal facilities. Birds are an important part of our environment. They serve as the proverbial canaries in the coal mine and tell us early on that something is not quite right with our environment. The decline and near extinction of the bald eagle, the brown pelican, and the peregrine falcon due to contaminants such as DDT and PCBs alerted us to the potential risks to humans from the widespread use of these chemicals. Birds such as hummingbirds are important plant pollinators. Birds are also beneficial in dispersing plant seeds. They control harmful insects. Birds are economically valuable to society. Each year, hunting and wildlife watching add billions of dollars into our economy. Exposed oil in an oil and gas facility has the potential to attract birds and other wildlife. Waterfowl and other aquatic birds may be attracted to pits and open tanks used to store and separate oil from produced water. Waterfowl are not the only birds at risk. Pits and exposed oil can attract hawks, owls, and songbirds. Other wildlife can also be exposed to oil or other harmful chemicals at oil and gas facilities. When birds come into contact with oil, the oil damages their feathers. Oiled birds will try to clean their feathers by preening, and in doing so, they will ingest the oil and suffer harmful effects. Feathers serve several critical functions. They enable flight. Feathers protect the body. They insulate the body by entrapping warm air and repelling water. And feathers allow species and sex recognition. Oil-soaked birds lose their buoyancy as the oil compromises the feathers' ability to repel water. The birds drown or they die of hypothermia, and the oil-soaked feathers cannot insulate the bird from temperature extremes. Birds preen meticulously to maintain their feathers. External oiling almost always leads to oil ingestion. Oil ingestion can cause direct damage to the gastrointestinal tract, such as ulcers, diarrhea, and decreased ability to absorb nutrients. Oil ingestion can lead to dehydration. Inhalation of oil vapors can cause pneumonia, neurological damage, or anemia. Secondary effects of oil include a reduced ability to fight infection or diseases. Scavengers or predators that consume oiled birds will ingest the oil. Oil can reduce reproduction in birds. Oil production skim pits, reserve pits, and flare pits containing oil or other harmful chemicals can attract and entrap birds and other wildlife. Other risks at oil and gas production facilities include spills, puddled oil due to leaking valves or wellheads, oil-filled containers or drip buckets. Reserve pits containing oil or oil-based products, such as oil-based drilling fluids, can entrap and kill migratory birds and other wildlife. The risk increases after the drilling equipment is removed and the reserve pit remains at the well pad. Reserve pits remaining for an extended period of time can spell trouble for wildlife, especially if the reserve pits contain any oil or other chemicals that can cause wildlife mortality. State oil and gas regulatory agencies typically allow oil operators to leave reserve pits in place after well completion to allow drilling fluids to evaporate prior to pit closure. The pits are allowed to remain in place up to 1 year in most western states. Disposal of fluids from hydraulic fracturing into pits can impact birds. Flowback water from hydraulic fracturing can contain surfactants, which can cause bird mortality. Surfactants reduce the surface tension of water, thus allowing water to penetrate through feathers and onto skin. This compromises the insulation properties of the feathers and subjects the bird to hypothermia. Loss of water repellency in feathers due to reductions in surface tension will cause the bird to become waterlogged. Loss of buoyancy will cause the bird to drown. Bird carcasses recovered from reserve pits in Colorado, Montana, North Dakota, and Wyoming include passerine songbirds, raptors, shorebirds, and waterfowl. Immediate removal of the drilling fluids followed by pit closure after well completion is the key to preventing wildlife mortality in reserve pits. The best options are to eliminate the use of open reserve pits and used closed-loop, pitless drilling systems or downhole disposal of drill cuttings. Pitless drilling or closed-loop drilling reduces the amount of drilling waste, recycles drilling fluids, and reduces drilling costs. Pitless drilling can reduce the volume of waste by 60 to 70%. Pitless drilling also conserves water and prevents soil contamination. Care is still required with closed-loop systems to prevent ponding of water in the solids disposal trenches. Drilling fluid treatment and reuse will reduce waste and disposal costs and will allow for the recovery and reuse of methanol, water, and brine. Covering reserve pits with netting will exclude birds and other wildlife if properly installed and maintained. Downhole slurry injection of drilling wastes poses less environmental impacts when properly managed and monitored, as the wastes are disposed deep underground and isolated from aquifers. Oilfield production skim pits, used to separate formation water from oil, pose a risk to birds and other wildlife if they contain oil or other harmful chemicals. Oil in these pits can make them wildlife death traps. Wildlife mortality in production skim pits can be avoided by using closed tanks, keeping the oil off the pits, or covering the pits with netting or other exclusionary devices. Oil in skim pits should be immediately removed to prevent wildlife mortality. Flagging will not prevent birds from entering or accessing skim pits. Netting must be properly installed and maintained to exclude birds and other wildlife from skim pits. Netting requires intensive maintenance to effectively keep birds and other wildlife from oil pits. Heavy snow can cause the net to sag into the pit fluid. The exposed pit fluid will attract and entrap birds. Birds landing in the exposed pit fluid can also become entangled in the net as they attempt to crawl out of the oil fluid. All holes and gaps should be closed to prevent entry by birds and other wildlife. The sides of the enclosure should be covered with a small mesh to prevent entry by small mammals and songbirds. Pits or open tanks designed to catch oil drips from flares should be covered with wire mesh. Any pooled oil should be immediately removed. Dehydrator tanks or tubs should be properly covered to prevent access by songbirds. Dehydrator tubs or dehy tubs have caused the mortality of hundreds of songbirds. Fluids in the dehy tubs attract insects, which then attract songbirds. Dehy tanks or tubs should be properly covered to exclude wildlife. Mesh size should be small enough to prevent entry by songbirds. Oil and gas production facilities should be kept clean and free of exposed oil to prevent bird and other wildlife mortality. All spilled oil should be cleaned up immediately. All hoses and valves should be properly secured to prevent drips and spills. Don't let small drips and spills become big problems. Drip buckets to catch drips from loadout valves can also entrap birds. Use drip containers with spring-closed lids. Small drips and spills can and do entrap birds and small wildlife. Water pooled in the well cellar can attract and entrap toads, lizards, small mammals, and birds. Well cellars should also be properly covered to exclude wildlife. By implementing these best management practices in oil and gas facilities, you can help conserve your fish and wildlife resources and ensure that they remain as part of our heritage for future generations to enjoy.